I figure, yeah, I figure. My mind's on you, mind's on you. Now you love somebody else.
¿Qué tal, amigos de Rich Music? Aquí con ustedes Leandro Soto y estoy aquí para otra edición más el podcast directamente desde Puerto Rico, porque allá está Chris Marshall, quien se une a nosotros en este episodio de hoy, en un podcast donde vamos a estar hablando acerca del campamento allá en Puerto Rico, en donde obviamente está Chris Marshall, Justin Quiles, Dalex y un sinnúmero de otros artistas que están listos para crear la música que ustedes estarán escuchando próximamente en todas las plataformas digitales. Bienvenido a Chris Marshall. You don't know Chris Marshall. How you doing, man?
Whoop, whoop. Yo, big up myself. You know, they have, everything is nice. Everything is iry.
I see
everything
you very Caribbean. You're in that Caribbean vibe, man. I see you.
Yes, well, Puerto Rico. We had Puerto Rico, so I have to be in the Caribbean vibe.
Yeah.
Because we are in the Caribbean. Know what I'm saying?
It ain't hard for you to do it because you come from the Caribbean. You're from there. You come from the island vibe. So tell us how it's been in these first couple days in the camp.
Well, the first couple of days in camp has been amazing. It's like a house full of crazy talents and everybody's throwing around melodies and styles and everything is so dope and crazy. It's like something like you'd have to see to believe, you know what I'm saying?
Man, I wish I was back there with you, but hey, I gotta get what they give me, and I'm here with you, and I already had the chance to speak with Dallas in one of these podcasts, and it's about that. I want to try to catch the vibe. I want to try to take it to our fans and to everybody who follows the Rich Music channel and get a feeling on how it is that all these hits come about, and I think you... in the role as you've been playing, not only composing but also producing, could tell us just that, right?
How the hits come about. I feel like it's a collective energy, and we have to give credit to the people who put all this stuff together. So the people handpicked all of the greats and put them together and be like, okay, this one, that one, do this, and rare, this one be good with this one, you know what I'm saying? And then we just gel and have fun. And I feel like if you have fun with a song, other people here, they're gonna have fun too. It's easy.
Yeah, for sure, no doubt. And who can you name, who are the artists that are with you guys in the camp right now? Who are those hand chosen guys that are making the hits of tomorrow?
Okay, we got the great Justin Quiles.
Yeah, okay, you know, okay, yeah.
We got the talented Dalex.
You know, versatile Dalex.
Versatile Dalex, and then we have other people working remotely like the Dimelefl and the Rike, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we have Simone Dice, crazy guitarist.
Definitely.
Yeah, and the list goes on. We have the whole team too, otherwise some musicians with the video and the social media and this and that. Yeah, everybody out here.
I catch the vibe. Can you explain to us how you guys divide the work? How you guys, okay, sit down, and I know you guys had like different made up studios and different rooms, but how do you guys get together and decide, okay, Chris, go ahead and work with Dalex for a bit and then go ahead and work with Justin? How does that come about?
Well, with the music things, we don't really like put one person over there and say, do that, whatever, just whatever you feel like doing. It's all about the vibe.
Okay.
And that's what I like about Rich Music. Like, somebody could over, even at the studio where we are, there are multiple studios. You could just walk into somebody's session and go with a vibe if you want to.
You're right. Same
thing here. Like, somebody be over there and somebody is just walking and be like, oh, boom, and you throw this shit around. It's like, oh yeah, I like that. Boom, boom. You could be gone after that. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's just like a whole vibe. Whatever clicks.
What's the process like for you though? Because in my opinion, and people who probably don't even know how a song comes about, I would think of the artist sitting down, listening to a beat, writing everything down on paper. Is that still how it's done, or is it is there an evolution to the way that we used to do it, or how is it done now?
There's no evolution and no correct way to write a song or create a song. You could start with the lyrics, you could start with the beat, you know what I'm saying? You could start with whatever. It's just, but the way I like to do it, I like to hear the beat first.
Yeah.
And then I just come up with a whole lot of melodies and then, take it from there. But that's not always the way it goes, but sometimes that's I prefer.
You prefer to get the beat and then maybe go from it, get a melody going, and then put some words to it?
Yep.
Okay. And, you know, it's kind of hard to ask you this.
Mm-hmm.
you've also shown some versatility, and we're gonna be speaking about your Martial Law EP. Already a song came out. I Fear. We're gonna be speaking about that too. But in that EP, I heard it. I heard it completely. I have it. I downloaded it. I put it in my phone. I know it hasn't come out. I know I probably did something wrong, but it's too fire, and I had to have it.
Okay.
So, yeah, I had to have it. I had to have it. I promise, I'm only consuming it myself. I'm not showing anybody until it comes out. But there's different rhythms
like
there.
It, man.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely do. And I want to congratulate you because I know you've been working hard on this EP, and it's coming along just fine. And releases are coming. We're going to get to that. But how do you pick and choose what vibe you're going to do? Are you going to go with that dance? Are you going to go with that reggaeton, R&B? Are you going to go with maybe a little more soca? I know it is. I know it's what the vibe feels right at the moment, but maybe you have one that you prefer to compose or to sing or to write.
Prefer? Well, it's in my thing. You know, people like me. I realize people like me because of the Jamaican flavor that I put on everything.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
So even if I'm gonna go outside of the dancehall or whatever, I'm still gonna put that Jamaican flavor on it because that's what people like. And let me not say expect because that kind of sound like, you know, one track. But that's the reason why people, you know, message me and they like that. So I just give them that. You know what I'm saying? It's easy going.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So you're gonna stick with whatever feels right, right? That's what you're gonna go with.
Yeah, I'm gonna stick with whatever feels right, but I'm still gonna do different stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like different genres mixed with what I do.
Yeah,
but I'm always gonna keep that Jamaican flavor going because that's me.
You know one thing that's gonna be highlighted with this Martial Law EP, and I keep getting ahead of myself, but I it's fire. I feel like Chris Marshall could be that guy in music, in urban music in general, that can put the best of both worlds together. And you did it in I Fear. You got you got Kiss Daniel, Nigerian major artist, and you got Justin Quiles, which is a major Spanish artist. And then you got your own Jamaican flow, Jamaican vibe. You put both worlds together, and I think that's something that in your career, it's something that you could really stand out doing.
Yeah, I agree. I totally agree.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
And that's one of the things I'm gonna continue doing. I'm gonna continue to collaborate. And I'm going to continue to put my Jamaican flavor on different genres, you know what I'm saying? And keep going.
Amen. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. For sure. We catch that vibe, Chris. I gotta ask you because I think it was after this whole COVID stuff or before this whole COVID stuff. It was like 3 or 4 months ago. I remember I had a sit down interview with you and you showed me a song with Dalex. Right now, you're with Dalex there. You've been having the chance all this week to speak with Dalex and to pretty much compose and work with Dalex along with all other guys. And in this song, Chris, you got Dalex to speak English. So we're gonna go back to that same point we just made.
That wasn't me.
I had to say it. Hey, I'm not gonna play the song. It's not released yet, but fans could look forward to one day listening Dalex singing in English. But I'm gonna go back to that same point because you got Dalex, major come up artist right now in the Latin music industry, and you made him or you put him to sing in English in your track. Talk to me about how that came up.
That was all Demelo Flow. Demelo Flow was like, it sounds good like that, let's do it like that. I'm like, okay, we down, boy. Actually, I got Justin to sing in English 2 days ago too.
So you got Justin to sing in English as well 2 days ago?
Yeah.
That's a first.
Yep.
I would expect Dalex because, you know, Dalex is on the R&B vibe.
Yeah, you got the R&B, you know what I'm saying? Yeah,
but Quiles is on that reggaeton perreo, you know what I mean?
You're going to be surprised when you hear this one, right?
Oh, man, I can't wait till you get back to Miami. Show me.
That's far down the line. Let's get back to here.
Let's get back. Let's get back to it, and let's dive in into Martial Law and the I Fear release. I think it's had a great acceptance from the fans. How do you feel from it? You got Kiss Daniel on Major Nigerian, as I mentioned before. You got Justin Quiles. I think this song, man, you really put it together, and it's a banger.
Yeah, I appreciate it. And I have to give thanks to Rich Music and the producer, Mafio.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
to help putting everything together, because everything, as we say, it's a collective energy. Like, you know, one man stands alone and no man is an island, you know what I'm saying?
So
it's everybody who involved, they put their piece together, and all the pieces come together, and that's what we created, the IFA record, which I'm very proud of. And I hear people telling me how much they love it, and sound like, I feel good, because like, that's the best part of like doing your work, and then somebody could be like, okay, that shit is amazing, I enjoy it. When are you gonna give us more? You know what I'm saying? Like, it's been a good ride so far. Just wanna take it to like the next level now.
I'm just gonna tell you, man, they're gonna get some more pretty soon.
Yep.
They're gonna get some more pretty soon. And in this song, I love the concept, and I don't know if any male guy around the world, if a guy can relate to this song,
yeah,
I don't know, that guy was probably, I don't know, Brad Pitt or something like that never had a girl that he liked fall for somebody else, and then you feel you fear,
yo,
right? Go ahead.
Even if the girl didn't fall for somebody else, it's still everyone's fear.
If you
feel happily married, but for all your life,
you're right.
You're still gonna have that fear, no matter how wife you don't, you know what I'm saying, or hubby or whatever don't have her mind.
But I think that's a new generation problem, though.
Yeah, because there's so much distractions.
I think that's a new generation problem. Like, I don't fear my grandfathers used to fear that, I don't know, my grandmother was gonna, maybe it happened, I'm not sure. It's, life is life, but I feel like what do you think? That's a new generation problem, right?
Well, I can't talk about the other generation. I could talk about this one.
Yeah, you're right.
Because I'm in this one, so me going to talk about the one that I wasn't in, I'm gonna say some things that I don't know.
But
I feel like this generation, like, there's a lot of distractions, especially with social media, and like, it's so easy for somebody to, like, you know, get up on somebody like that, you know what I'm saying?
So there is a music video that's gonna come out for this song, the I Fear. Mm-hmm. You already saw the lyric videos all over the place.
Okay, this music video is gonna be fun. It's gonna be one of those music videos that you're gonna watch.
I know.
Some people are gonna be happy, some people's gonna be mad. Like, there's gonna be, I can't wait to see the comments.
Well, don't tell me the story yet. Let's wait till it comes out.
No, I'm not gonna tell you. That's what I'm saying. That's a surprise.
You already gave me enough with Justin Keeley singing in English. So that's enough. That's enough. And we already know Dalex is doing it too. But man, how do you feel this song can help you catapult your career?
This song is already helping me to catapult, like, my listeners on Spotify and my subscribers and YouTube and stuff like that. It's been going up, and and so we have to just give thanks and keep going. And the music video is not even dropped yet, and like, we have certain like promotional ideas that we haven't, you know what I mean, done yet.
Yeah,
feel me?
I haven't
sung the acoustic version yet, you know what I'm saying? Oh, even a guitar.
I know you got that cooking up.
What I'm saying, sitting with a guitarist and just rocking out and let them really hear, like, okay.
Let's hope you do it someplace in Puerto Rico.
I'm shooting for that.
Let's hope so. So I Fear, we got the Martial Law, which consists of 8 songs.
Mm-hmm.
You got
it's actually 7. The first track that's there is just an introduction.
The intro, which I heard, and it's, man, it gave me goosebumps. It gave me
slow mic.
It gave me goosebumps. You got your wordings in there and key phrases that you say, that really put out what you want to do, which is get to the masses. And mm-hmm. I know how hard you've been working to try to achieve that. And in this EP, man, I know that you put in your hard work. You've been working on it for a while, right?
Actually, I've been working on it since last year. After that Anita record came out, Tuyo, which did very well.
It's still doing well.
It's actually still doing well. I'm surprised. Yeah. It seems like it's going to become a classic.
Probably.
Yeah, so after that, Rich Music announced EP, so I started working, and up to now, this is it.
Yeah. Now you got the final product, and it's going out there, and people are paying attention, and people are really liking it. Next single is gonna be Ready.
Mm-hmm.
Dope song, club banger, different songs.
Yep.
Talk to me. Don't give me no concepts, but talk to me. What does this song make you feel?
Is it Ready? No. Ready is a real Jamaican song. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So this is not as deep as I Fear with a story. This is actually like me talking to a girl, tell her, make sure she's ready. to dance with me, the Jamaican dance called Wine, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
This slow one. This is what happens before you fear that she's gonna like somebody else.
Yes, this is what happens. This is how you get to fall in love.
Yeah. And let's keep going through all the track list before we get into some videos I got for you. So I'm gonna play and I wanna see your reaction from it. Next song after Ready is gonna be Money Talk with Conscience. One of your boys, dope artist, real dope artist. And then we got to shift the conversation here because this song talks about real life problems and things that are going on right now in the world. You're sending a message out here. So you already got some for the Jowls out there, right? Mm-hmm. You already got something for the club. And now you're putting out something for the conscience.
Yeah, social commentary.
Yeah.
Like talk about something. Because it don't make sense to have a whole EP of songs with the same subject.
Of course.
Know what I mean?
Of course.
So we have to talk about different things. Like, and as I said before, that last time I spoke with you, that I write my songs from my experiences. You know what I mean? So this is like one of my experiences or something that's on my consciousness. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Of course.
So we need to make money.
Hey, man, I'm with you, bro. We gotta make that talk. We got to make that paper, man, and we got to make it talk.
Yeah.
So, yeah, man, I really like it because this refreshed a little bit. You know what I mean? Like, it gave us something else to look forward to from your career and from your versatility. So I got to give it up to you on that song. Going along over here from the track list, you got Money Talk, then you got that Mood song. Nice little groove. Yeah.
That's a super, super Jamaican.
Yeah, definitely.
The lyrics in that is so dirty. I don't know if you guys like would watch like the Jamaican parties and see the girls just go wild. That's one of those kind of songs. You know what I'm saying?
One of those songs that they jump from the stage and land on the guy, that type of stuff?
That's one of those. Because you know, we do, as I'm saying, we're doing it, the EP, that anybody could listen and be like, oh, I like this song. You feel me? Like, they probably don't like everything, but there's going to be a vibe. A Jamaican could come and listen. A Puerto Rican could come and listen. You know what I'm saying? An African could come and listen.
Yeah,
like, anybody from everywhere, you know, somebody from Europe, you know what I'm saying? Could be like, okay, yeah, I like that vibe. I could pick that vibe from it. Like, you know what I'm saying? A little bit of everything. So that is going to be like the dance Jamaica. You know what I'm saying? And there's a lot of people out there in the world that like that bounce and like the party to the Jamaican style and that would be able to play in like parties and stuff, the bounce. I think that one is going to do really, really good. And it's one of the dirtiest songs I've ever made in my life.
Is that something that maybe you're going to keep doing if it, you know, how do you feel about that? Because most of your songs, they're on the clean line. And in this one, I think you drifted a little bit away from it.
Yeah, but as I'm saying, you have to cater to all the audiences.
Yeah, for
sure.
So
what about the girls that want to hear some dirty stuff? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they want to jump off the stage onto some guy.
Yeah, you have to cater. What about a girl that want to jump on you and whine on you and something like that? Yeah, you have to cater to those people too. Just like we cater to people who are in love or people, you know what I mean?
I'm going to leave this, the sixth song at the end, towards the end. But the last song is called Work. Love that song as well. Talk to me a little bit about the groove on that one.
Okay, that one, the Mellow Flow, so Mike produced and me.
Okay.
So I was in my I think it was my bedroom one night, and I was rocking out. I'm like, this sounds kind of dope. And I finished dancing to Flow. And he's like, fire, fire, fire. But you got to send it to me. We need to fix it. And then he fixed it up. We went back in the studio, had me switch some stuff around, and that was a finished product. Slow Mike came and did his stuff, whatever.
Dope.
So, yeah. Yeah, then, so that one has like a reggaeton vibe to it.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
So probably in the future, I don't know. Probably somebody will be like, oh, Chris, remix.
Let me get on that in Spanish, and then we're going to make you sing in Spanish. We got to make you.
I want to do that so bad at some point.
You feel you're going to get there? You feel you're going to be able to achieve it?
Yeah, I think I'll be able to achieve it.
You're practicing your Spanish? You've been learning Spanish?
Yeah, of course. I'm always in the Spanish countries and everybody around me is Spanish. Vamos, so I have to. Vamos, that is a must.
Vamos a ver si es verdad. Vamos a ver si es verdad, Chris. ¿Cómo te ha ido en Puerto Rico?
Okay. He left me there. I don't know, simple stuff like
right, direction. I'm going to repeat it slowly because maybe I spoke too fast. I got to be fair with you. So, ¿cómo te ha ido en Puerto Rico?
So, it's how something in Puerto Rico.
Yeah, how's it going in Puerto Rico?
So, oh, okay, you know, I know it was how, como. Yeah.
You got it, vamos. You got it. You're on it.
Okay. Puerto Rico es muy bien.
There you go. So you're learning. You mentioned that you, with this EP, you're trying to reach different audiences. Maybe open up your make it a little more broad, you know, maybe to get into different fields. And with this last song that I'm going to mention, it's the sixth song on your EP, Martial Law. Uh-huh. You're getting into Colombia a little bit with Chucky Town, right?
Yeah.
This song, Tune Up. Uh-huh. This got a little bit of everything. It's got a little bit of wind up. It's got a little bit of soca. It's got a little bit of Caribbean rhythms in there. Yeah.
One of my favorites, you know. Yeah, because as what you say, it's a mixture of everything. And then Chucky Town just killed that. Like, they murdered that, you know what I'm saying? Spoke to them today. They are super excited. I'm excited about this one too. And it's actually saying turn up. But it's because it's Jamaican, you know, we break the English, you call it broken English, so we say turn up, you know,
like,
yeah,
okay,
turn up,
okay, turn up, but you cut the R a little bit.
Yeah, like, that's how we talk in Jamaica. Yeah. If you're going to say burn, them say bun up.
Okay. I see. You're not gonna get me to sing in Jamaican. I promise you that. You're not going to make me do that.
I promise you, I'm gonna make you sing in Jamaica. The song is gonna keep going, and you're gonna sing, and you're wondering like, "Oh, I'm doing it."
I promise. Next episode we got together, next interview, I'll give it a try if you write something down for me. I'll give it a try.
All right, cool. Okay, that's a challenge.
Let's do it. If you write something down for me, I'll give it a try. Last thing we can do is just try. You know what I mean?
Okay, definitely. That's a challenge. You got to do that. That's going to be fun.
I'm down. We're going to do that. I'm going to write it down. We're going to do the next interview down at the Hive, wherever it is that we're at.
It's probably going to be the Hive.
I told you I had some surprises for you in videos.
Okay.
I want you to see this. You already mentioned this song during the interview already. Mm-hmm. But I want you to see this. And when it's done, I want you to tell me how much your life, your career has changed since this moment. Me and you, I fuck up with you for one for sure in a bedroom. Me and you, I know you really want it, so let's wake up all in here, boss, baby. Have a couple tricks that know me want for sure to you. All of my men move it, I'm so into you. Mama see that you're the one, I'm in love to see your wine. Girl, you should take a time. Oh, man.
Oh, my God. All right. I've been in the music industry so many years.
Yeah.
And I've been producing since high school. And that there is one of my most memorable experiences in music.
Where was that video shot?
It was shot in Búzios, Rio de Janeiro, in Brazil.
So. Right there, I can notice how music has been able to take you different places. You're in Puerto Rico right now. It's obviously taking you back home. And it's definitely taking you to places that you probably thought
never
you
thought you would have been to.
Okay, perfect. You said it. You never thought you would have been to. So talk to the audience and tell them how much this song, Tú y Yo with Anita, helped your career, helped you keep going mentally, and how it's changed you completely.
Okay. I feel like the most significant change with that song is a lot of people who never considered me as an artist.
Okay.
I never taken me serious. Started to be like, okay, we need to take this guy serious now. Like, he's doing his thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
I love this one, you know what I'm saying? So that's what put the artist stamp, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that kind of catapult the thing to a level, and I really appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? Big up to Benno Flo and Simone Dice and Anita. Beautiful and talented Anita, you know what I'm saying, for giving me that opportunity.
Yeah, of course.
To catapult my career to the next step, so Amen. We can be going out to the next step now, because it steps, you know, all the way up to the top.
This next one, I think, is really going to get to you, but I'm going to ask you the same thing. Just tell me how much your life has changed since this moment.
Oh my God, and I went there, I had like a hero's welcome. Everybody just wanted to come out and have a drink with me. Like everybody, people woke up out their beds just to come say hi to me. And like, it was just an amazing feeling. I feel like I never left. I brought with me two Latin guys and they never seen them before. They treat them with mad respect. And it was a really amazing feeling. We had a good time. Most of the people that in the video is people that I know. So it means a lot to me. Even I show people that are from there and are not there right now. And they say it brings tears to their eyes, it means something. And I wouldn't rather go anywhere to shoot that video if it's actually talking about there.
All right, so everybody, that video is shot where I'm actually from. So you can see I'm coming from a far ways, you know what I'm saying? So it means a lot to me because I was able to go back where I was from and see everybody that I grew up with, you know what I'm saying? And bring people from and my environment that I am now and go over there and we mesh with everybody and like they were well like accepted, respected, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah,
that's a little piece of my heart because that's where I'm from.
Yeah,
so those are the people that I grew up with actually in the video.
Dope.
So if people want to see what created and where I was born and bred and why I'm the way I am, then you can watch that video and actually see a piece. You know, I'm seeing and kind of understand. So, yeah, it's always going to be there through my whole career. So anybody could just always go back and look at the beginning of.
And this was your first video, right? This was your first video?
Yeah.
Man, how did it feel to have your first video shot in your hometown? Not a lot of artists can say that.
Yeah, that was an amazing feeling, though. And I'm happy I did it because then we always have that root.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. You shot it where you're from, and the song has to do a lot with what where you come from and the people that you grew up with, right?
Mm-hmm.
Deya Dog. What does that mean?
Medea means I am here.
Okay. So
well, Medea, we just say, I don't know how to explain to translate. Medea, it just means I am here with my friends. We call them dogs, and they are dog.
Yeah,
so okay. I'm here with my friends, yeah, chilling on the corner. I'm sipping my Guinness and I'm smoking marijuana.
Dope.
You know what I'm saying? Dope. Yeah, so it's just basically explaining like what I'm doing.
Many years ago, there was one song in Jamaica and worldwide that you put a little grain in of work in. Temperature from Sean Paul.
Yeah. Yeah.
I never knew you. Man, I used to vibe to that song when I was in high school. I used to go to these little dances in high school, and I used to vibe with that song. And I never thought I would get to know and have the chance to speak to the producer of that song. Tell us how that came about. How did Chris Marshall get his name on the credits for Sean Paul's Temperature?
Well, I made that beat an old broken laptop I had in my living room.
Okay.
You know what I mean? It was some of the first Fruity Loops, which they call FS2, you know, that came out. I used all stock plugins. And I brought it to a producer, and he made all that stuff happen because he liked it so much. He's like, he sent it to Sean Paul, loved it, whatever. Yeah. And that song has been like a life-changing experience. That song changed my life. You know what I mean? It's one of the reasons why I'm here and talking to you right now. That's one thing in my life I would never change.
Yeah.
That song was like a beautiful experience all the way up to now. Even right now, yesterday, people still license that song for dancing videos and TV episodes, and it's a classic.
Yeah, definitely, it changed.
You know what I mean?
In some way, it helped Sean Paul's career as well. He already had bangers. He already had a career going.
Mm-hmm.
But this song, I think it really helped him worldwide, right?
Yeah, like it re-catapulted him back into stardom. It's his longest running number one record. So it was a number one record in the whole entire world.
Wow.
You feel me? Sean Paul only had two of those, and this one is the only one that was a classic. So if arguable, we could say it's Sean Paul's biggest solo record. A record by himself.
Because
he had bigger records, I think, with features.
Yeah.
So arguably, you could say Sean Paul's biggest solo record.
Hey, yo, Chris, man, this has been a wonderful time. Appreciate your time, bro. Appreciate you having the vibes to come on this podcast. And it's not for me. It's for your fans. It's for the mm-hmm. Rich Music Channel. And ultimately, for the Chris Marshall career. So, man, just I wish you nothing but the best, and we're gonna keep it in touch.
Yeah, man, and it's always a pleasure talking to you. Have a nice vibe.
Yeah.
Because you don't know the energy more time. I like energy, you know.
Appreciate it.
And
that.
You give up a night energy, so just bounce back on the conversation. Let's keep going. So I respect that, you know what I mean? So
appreciate
thank
that.
You for having me.
I appreciate that. That was Chris Marshall for you and Rich Music YouTube channel. Lo tengo que despedir en español, Chris. Aunque tú no me entiendas por ahora, porque te voy a poner a cantar en español en alguna canción, como tú lo harás conmigo en jamaiquino. Gracias por estar con nosotros aquí en el canal de YouTube de Rich Music. Recuerda darle suscribir, darle like si te gustó nuestro contenido. Y quédate ahí sentado porque viene mucho, mucho más para todos ustedes. Gracias. Leandro Soto de este lado.
Peace. I won't surrender. Don't drift away. As long as you're my young girl.